So I received one of the best questions from a viewer not too long ago, and they said, Kim, we saw your video on proposals. We thought it was fantastic. Yes, do not propose until the client is absolutely ready. But what if you can't move forward in the sales cycle until you propose? Listen, this is a great question, you guys, and I want you to understand where you are versus where you need to be. We talk a lot in KO Sales U about aligning the sales cycle to the buyer's journey. When we know where the buyer is, we can determine where we are in the sales cycle. And near the very end is proposals and negotiations. But what happens if the client isn't completely lead qualified yet? What happens if they completely don't understand your value that you're trying to exchange in that value discovery section, and now they're automatically asking for the proposal? I get it. It happens, especially when we're dealing with those bigger clients, those government agencies, those corporate ones, and we gotta play the game. We have to play the game, otherwise we can't move forward. So if you're going ahead and sending a proposal, call it what it is. It's a brochure with a price tag on it. It is ultimately not a proposal because you cannot propose until you understand the complete value of what you are exchanging with your client. The proposal is a summary. It is an understanding about where the client is, where they want to be, the bridge to the solution of how we're going to help them get there, and then the price becomes almost completely irrelevant because when we've solved that ultimate problem for that client, when they've achieved that ultimate success, the price is just an investment to help them get there faster. But until we know all of that information, what we've ultimately done is we've given them a brochure with a price tag on it. It is our opening conversation. It is our opening offer. But no means does this actually mean that it's the proposal. What we end up doing at this point in time is we deliver that information to the client, always in person if we possibly can, and the immediate conversation after that point in time is, when do we follow up to continue the conversation? When do we continue to dig into that? When can I confirm that the assumptions I've had to make, because you have to, you don't have all the information, you had to assume up till this point, when can we sit down, Mrs. Customer, and confirm all the assumptions I've made up until this point hold accurate? Continue the conversation as if you are exactly where you are in the sales cycle, whether that is a lead qualification or value discovery. Just because you ruined the book by allowing the client to see the last couple pages of it does not mean that you are stopping the read. You have to continue to go through the journey, go through the story. Yes, spoiler alert, the client already knows approximately how it will end, but that does not mean that you have to stay there. When you are creating enough value with the client, continuing the process the same way you are, you still have an opportunity to shine. You have an opportunity to upsell, create even more value. They just have an idea about how that book will end. Go back and ask yourself, do I know where I am with the cycle? Do I know all of my lead qualifications, my budget, my authority, my need, my timeline? Does the client completely understand the value exchange that we've created? And if the answer is no to any of those questions, that's where you actually are in the sales cycle. Not at proposal stage, not negotiating something that they've already seen. Continue the story and you will work your way to getting the deal even faster.